one of those shows I can...
Oh, do you want to go and tell us you've done the marathon?
Hey, what about Portugal, Rachel?
Yeah. Oh, it's all coming out now, isn't it?
Looks good, kill. Oh. That was a blow, that was.
Well, that's what it looked like.
No.
Say, what, no. Why don't you start turning on me? Have a fight with him.
It's 10 to 7.
Hey, what have I done wrong?
You started it.
I didn't say anything
happy,
about Portugal.
Happy sound of radio.
Rachel, all I was referring to was the time that you and I were...
Oh, for God's sake, Carrie, what about you and Longman in that hotel? Let's talk about that, for God's sake. And
Monday,
Dominic,
Tuesday,
what about...
Happy days.
What about...
Butlins!
I was sick.
Travel sick.
What about Butlins?
Yeah.
What about the next day at Butlins when they were showing the manager man round? And you were hiding. Right, okay. Right, now we're all happy. Now we should start the show. 1,341.
Good morning from the Chris Moyles Show. Good morning from the Chris Moyles Show. Good morning from the Chris Moyles Show.
Right, hello, good morning, and welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hello.
International Radio 1.
Okay, going to start with a nice workout this morning. It's getting nice and limbered up and feeling nice and lively. Dave, you sit this one out. You're all right. Okay, it's Eric Prydz. Call on me, and then we'll have a bit of The Killers and Human right here on BBC. Radio 1.
Loads of people who've been to see The Killers and a few gigs in London they've done recently said they were very good. That's The Killers there singing A Human.
I've still not seen them yet.
Whatever.
Ever.
Really?
Mm.
They're very good.
I'd like to see them.
Yeah, the band are very... He's a bit ropey sometimes.
Are we human?
Sorry.
Or are we dancers?
Anyway, sing it, Brandon.
Are we human?
Give us a smile, give us a tap dance.
Or are we dancers?
Good morning, everybody. This is BBC Radio 1. Dominic Byrne, is that a new shirt you're wearing?
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. It's brand new from yesterday.
You know, I
bought it.
I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but we know each other that well.
Yeah.
We know if you're wearing a new item of clothing.
I know. I thought it's time to freshen up my wardrobe collection for summer 09.
I quite like it.
So you bought how many new shirts?
Well, I just bought this one at the moment.
So you bought one shirt to freshen up your wardrobe collection.
Exactly.
The reason why you notice, though, is because it's not a black T-shirt.
That's true. Well, I thought, you know, it's summer and I should be reflecting this in my clothing.
But it should be reflected in the weather.
Yeah, that's true.
It does look like July's shirt on the dog blanket calendar, I think.
Do you think so?
It's very similar, yeah.
Well, I like this one. This is nice.
You're going for a lot of pink at the moment, I've noticed.
Yeah, I am going for pink. It's a colour that suits me. It's a colour I feel comfortable in and I like it.
Why not?
Yeah.
It's nice when men do feel comfortable in pink,
I think. Exactly. Men look really lovely in pink.
Mm. Not all. You have to have the right skin colour.
No, I generally think it always works with most men.
You think?
I think you need to be quite dark.
Well, Tom's got a few pink T-shirts, though, and he's not dark, he's blonde.
This is like Gok Wan.
Why are you doing?
On Radio 1.
I don't know.
What's wrong with you? Harry in Bedford has texted in saying, I just got out of bed and I've gone from listening to watching.
Oh,
isn't that nice? Thank you, mate.
Mm.
Bye.
Love the show, says Dr. Rich in Leeds. It's nice to put faces to your voices. Good, because we've only been doing the show for 5.5 years in the morning. So it's nice to know that you finally know what Dominic looks like.
Hello.
Anyway, thanks for watching the live streaming. Rach, do you want to do an update?
Mm.
We went from... this morning, we started off the show with 23 people watching the live feed.
That's rubbish, isn't
it? It's now at... 2,086.
Now, that is a record for 7 a.m, isn't it?
I think you're probably right. It is, yeah. 2,086.
But if every one person told a friend, go and watch now, we could double that.
Yeah, but if every one person who was listening and went and watched it, we'd have like a few million.
Yeah.
I know, but my point is, Dave, because I know you're frowning, trying to spread the word.
Yeah.
Tell people.
Yeah, Dave, spread the word.
If
yeah,
they told two people, we could triple it.
Dave, what would happen if we told three people?
It would quadruple.
Right.
Literally.
See?
Would it, or would that triple?
Hang on,
I think
right?
That would triple, wouldn't it?
Hang on, if there's one person tells three people, you'd have four people. Is that four times as much or three times as much?
That's four. One's four is four. That's four times.
Four times. You see, I was right first time. 701.
Bit of maths.
Evie is texting. Evie says it's the first time I've watched, and it's pretty dandy. Although Dave does look a little shifty.
Ooh, shifty's a new one.
Know. What does shifty mean?
Oh no! See, I'll get defensive, a bit dodgy. Dave. You know, shifty might mean.
Is this why I always get stopped at airport security?
You always have to take your shoes off.
Always.
That's not a joke. You do, don't you?
Always.
Every single
even,
time.
Even wearing sandals, they take them off, which is ridiculous because you can see underneath them.
When I went away on Friday, when Sophie and I went to New York for the weekend, just because I get paranoid about that airport detector thing, the security thing. So I have a system now. You know when you're queuing up?
Hmm. Yeah.
So I literally put my hands in my pockets and it's keys, coins, lighter, whatever, all goes in my jacket pocket, watch, everything goes in. So by the time I get to, right, then the jacket goes off, that goes in the tray, and then I check all my pockets, belt, take the belt off, I make sure everything's, sunglasses, everything's in there. That's fine, because I don't, my challenge is to not beep, right?
Hmm.
Like a normal person.
Yeah.
As opposed to if you do beep, you feel guilty.
Mm.
You feel really bad. Beep! You're like that. I haven't done anything, I've done nothing wrong. And Sophie walked through, I swear in my life, she walks through the security thing, and it goes, beep, and she goes, what have you left in your pocket? And even the guy went, he hasn't even walked through yet, love. How can that be him? Well, it's always him, and then I walked through, nothing, I'm like that. The smug feeling I had when I walked past her. Yeah, go on, sort yourself.
Have you noticed that you can now walk through with change in your pocket and not beep?
Can you?
Which is a new thing. In the olden days, coins used to make you beep, but now you can keep them in.
Really?
Sorry?
Do you still get petrified at that bit?
I don't like airports.
At all?
That whole bit. I hate it.
But you do hate that security thing. You've properly gone
really?
A little bit weird.
Yeah.
Do you not know that?
No.
No.
She gets flying. The plane could be doing loop-de-loops and she wouldn't give a monkey. She'd be asleep.
Well, like when we flew to Belfast and we had a big bang and you were absolutely fine, weren't you?
I was asleep.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just get really, really nervous going through all that bit. I hate it.
It's weird because I'm scared of turbulence and the plane kind of bouncing around a little bit. Mm. You know, you're
me
very
too.
Similar.
Yeah.
Some people are scared of takeoff. Some people are scared of landing. Some people are, a lot of people are scared of crashing.
Yeah, yes. Most people. Yeah.
Rachel doesn't give a monkeys about any of those. She's scared of the airport security bit. Well, all you got to do is walk through an arch. That's it.
What do you think's going to happen?
I don't know. I just don't like it.
Beep!
I had fall to the floor.
I had my bag searched in front of everyone last time I flew because I accidentally kept a water bottle in
yeah,
there.
Yeah, you did.
You bad,
and
bad
I was
man.
Made to feel like a criminal.
Well, they have to check everything.
I know,
there,
and
they
did their job, and they were right.
Well, anyway, I got through all fine the weekend. It was all good. Shoes off, everything.
Did you high-five the security guard on the other end?
No, I always find that they don't appreciate that.
Do they not?
Yeah.
It's not advised, is it?
In the same way that when I was once going from Leeds Bradford Airport, go on Leeds Bradford, up to Glasgow, and this woman says to me, excuse me, can I just have a look in your bag, please? And I went, sure, my little carry-on bag. Mm. And I had everything really neatly packed. So I had, like, a book on the bottom, and then I had, like, my MP3 player, and my headphones, and I had a little wash bag or something, and I had something else. And I had it all really neatly packed. And she took everything out the bag, took it all out, looked at the bag, and went, okay, that's fine. And she went to move away. And I went, excuse me, can you put it all back in now, please? Mm. That was the wrong thing to say.
Really?
She gave me a look like I'd just urinated on her new shoes. Which I had done, but that was purely accidental. Anyway, they wouldn't let me on the flight. Something to do with legal laws and being drunk and urinating and stuff. But I don't want to talk about that stuff.
Digital. FM. Online. This is BBC Radio 1.
That last bit was obviously a joke, by the way.
Yeah.
Anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening this morning. We've got some good stuff coming up today. Music-wise, in the next half hour of the show, we're going to play our little LaRue parody of Bulletproof. And we'll play Kings of Leon as well. Let's first of all get the news from Dominic Byrne and the sport from Carrie Davis at 6 minutes past seven.
GPs criticise the way swine flu is being handled.